Wrong Turn franchise. Full timeline explained. Wrong Turn. The deformed cannibals of the Wrong Turn movie series have scared the forest of West Virginia so much that we have to think twice before planning a trip there. The cannibals in this movie, whoever they are, hunted people one by one and ate them. They are smart, know how to create and set up traps, and have excellent skills using an assortment of weapons. One wrong turn, and you will be left to run for your lives as they come after you. Wrong Turn started as just another slasher movie. The first one in 2003 was undoubtedly an average movie at best. But this is a franchise in which sequels were better. Wrong Turn 2, Dead End, is 1,000 times better than the first one, despite being a direct-to-video. And this movie is what made people become fans of the Wrong Turn franchise. Then, a prequel was released. Another direct-to-video that kind of explained how the cannibal family came into existence. Because each writer and director had different takes on this cannibal family and showed a different part of their life, the central story is challenging to follow. It is easier to get confused and give up on the movie series simply because it does not make any sense. But we suggest that you hang on to it. Wrong Turn movies are definitely better than they let on. Once you have a context of how things are happening, and when they happened, the overall story becomes easier to consume. We're going to give you that context in this video. In this video, we'll talk about the complete timeline of all Wrong Turn movies. Now, be sure to follow along us, because one wrong turn, and the whole thing will become confusing again. We're going to explain the series of events not in the order they happened in, but the movies they were told in. Since filmmakers frequently use flashbacks in the movies, they exist to put things into context and understand certain events in more depth. We're going to take the same path to explain the timeline. And yes, there are spoilers. This video is going to be a big one, so grab something to eat as well. Ready? Let's start. Hello there, everybody. Before we get into our list, we have a very small request. If you like our content, please support us by subscribing to our channel and clicking the little bell icon up in the corner to get notifications. This is a small click for you, but means a lot to us. Thank you, and let's begin. Number one. Wrong Turn, 2003. It shows us how the rock climbers, Rich and Haley, are pulled into the forest and murdered in a remote forest of West Virginia. 3 days later, in the present, a young student named Chris is heading for a business meeting when he comes across a traffic jam caused by a chemical spill on the road. He asks the elderly man at the gas station for an alternate route, and the man suggests he used the dirt road that leads to Bear Mountain. His car later collides with an SUV of a group of 5 friends, and it is punctured. But some of them soon realize that this wasn't an accidental puncture, as they see a barbed wire tied to the tree. And as the 6 of them start to find a way out of it, they find themselves being hunted by mountain men, because they're stuck. Now, all youngsters are stuck in the forest with their cars not working to survive against expert cannibal hunters who come after them one by one with an assortment of weapons and strategies. The mountain men hunting them are 3 brothers who have deformed faces and are cannibals. With the names One Eye, Sawtooth, and 3 Finger, their names vividly describe the distinctive feature. In a battle of survival, only Chris and Jesse from the group of 5 friends survive. Chris burns down the cabin with the cannibal brothers in it, and Jesse and Chris escape in a pickup truck. But in the post-credits scene, the investigating officer is attacked by 3 Finger, the only surviving brother. Although Wrong Turn did decently at the theaters, it was not well received. It had gratuitous gore, and it's practically impossible to distinguish from other slasher flicks. Wrong Turn neither offered anything new, nor does it have anything to say. But what made the franchise loved by the audience was its sequel, and that is...
It's all you got, bitch!
Number 2, Wrong Turn 2, Dead End, 2007. It begins with the singer and actress Kimberly Caldwell driving through a remote area in West Virginia, looking for the location of the reality show she is participating in. She accidentally hits a teenager and attempts to save him. The boy turns out to be a cannibal from the mountains. He, brother, and Three Finger cut Kimberly in half and drag her into the forest. Meanwhile, a team of reality show contestants, host, and crew have reached the location to shoot the apocalypse, ultimate survivalist. They start worrying about Kimberly's absence, but as the show begins, the abduction of crew members starts taking place. And this time, Three Finger isn't alone. He has a family comprising of Ma, Pa, brother, and sister. Two contestants even watch the pregnant Ma give birth to a deformed child who would come to be known as Three Toes. And here is when a bit of the cannibal family's past is told to the audience. When Dale, the show's host, enters the mutant family's cabin, he finds the old man from the gas station. The very man from the previous movie who suggested Chris take the alternate route. The old man is actually the caretaker of the family. Their deformity and mutation were a result of inbreeding and dumping of toxic waste by a paper in the river 30 years ago. The old man is the caretaker of Three Finger, One Eye, and Sawtooth. He takes the step to avenge the death of two of his sons when Dale blows up the man with a stick of dynamite. Of the reality show participants, only Nina and Jake survive by the end of the movie, who drive away in Kimberly's abandoned sports car. And of the inbred cannibal family, only Three Finger and Three Toes survive. The film rolls credits after showing that Three Finger is feeding the little one toxic waste from a bottle and a human finger. With Joe Lynch as the director and Turi Meyer and Al Septian as the writers, the movie took a turn for the good. They understood what was missing from the first movie and why the audience was disconnected. They gave the inbred cannibal family a backstory instead of making them the meaningless killers that they were. They also showed that the old man at the gas station was their caretaker, that the family is a victim of a tragedy they faced 30 years ago. Dead End was crisper and had genuine scary bits, which the original movie before this severely lacked. But the exciting thing is, the films get better from here on. Number 3, Wrong Turn 3, Left for Dead, 2009. Fast forward a few years after the events of Dead End, Three Finger and Three Toes are the only surviving members of the inbred mutant cannibal family in the forest of West Virginia. Three Toes has grown up, but still maintains the childish innocence and is being brought up by Three Finger. Now, when three prison guards are responsible for the transfer of three prisoners, they take the road to an abandoned paper mill. Their bus crashes into the woods as a tire gets entangled with barbed wire set up by Three Finger. They are forced to complete the journey on foot, but soon they find themselves falling in traps and lost in the forest. Since Three Toes is not yet as smart as Three Fingers, his traps are quickly jumped over, and he gets beheaded. When Three Fingers finds out, he goes on a vengeance spree to kill everyone. The human survivors find an armored truck full of money, but it is overlooked since saving their lives is the priority here. By the end of the movie, only Nate and Brandon survive. Nate manages to stab Three Finger in the head with a meat hook, but sometime later, when Nate returns to the forest to get the money from the armored truck, he is attacked and killed by Brandon, followed by Brandon being attacked by an unknown cannibal. Like Dead End, Left 4 Dead was also released direct to video. And what makes this story unique is its take on the inbred cannibal family. In the first movie, they were a family of ruthless cannibals. In the second, they had family. But what happens when that family is reduced to two members? Through the story of Three Toes, director Declan O'Brien and writer James Delaney show that they are also humans and feel emotion. Three Toes is just a child who dies a tragic death. Yes, he too would grow up to become a cannibal, but he is still a child. They are just a family trying to survive in the forest because they are not like others. They have been rejected by society, as shown in previous movies. Now, they only have each other. When Three Toes dies, Three Finger gets angry, as even his last family member is taken away from him. This is the first of three movies Declan would direct. And in all of his films, he gives a human touch to the antagonist. We have to remember that while we now know why they became like they did, we still don't know how and why they are cannibals. And that is explored in the next movie. Number 4. Wrong Turn 4. Bloody Beginnings. 2011. And now, we travel all the way back to 1974 to understand the cannibal family better. It turns out that Sawtooth, Three Finger, and One Eye come from a lineage of cannibals. Whatever their family was, it's inbreeding that made them more tolerant to pain and physically stronger. Because someone in the family was exposed to toxic waste in the paper mill, it resulted in a mutation passed on from one generation to the next. Both the inbreeding and chemical exposure make it ambiguous as to which mutation is the result of which factor. This makes them a unique and interesting group of people to study. That's what the doctors at Glenville Sanatorium in West Virginia are doing. They have hundreds of extraordinary people like them behind bars, but not for long. The Hillikers, the cannibals, cause an uprising and free everyone that is locked behind bars. They kill every person working in the asylum, and then escape, except for the Hillikers. 29 years later, when a group of youngsters out to snowboard take shelter in an abandoned building, the Glenville Sanatorium, as the snowstorm enrages outside, they find themselves being hunted by the three killers. Since we all know that this is a prequel and the Hillikers survive, it makes the movie boring and predictable because we know everyone's going to get killed. This is the movie in which Declan O'Brien served as the director and also wrote the story. After the first two movies, which told almost nothing about who these inbred cannibals were and where they're from, O'Brien took a step back to explore the past. And one can say he shouldn't have done it because he didn't actually show the past. He revealed that the three brothers come from a family of cannibals, and then it becomes any other slasher movie. Even then, most of the film takes place in 2003, the same year the first movie was released, implying that there isn't much time difference between the events of Bloody Beginnings and Wrong Turn. Well, anyway, we move on to the next movie.
Hold it right there!
Number 5. Wrong Turn, Bloodlines. 2012. Bloodlines is a direct sequel to Bloody Beginnings, as this is where O'Brien actually tells the story of the Hillikers. Led by the beloved Hellraiser star Doug Bradley, the movie follows five youngsters who visit a forest in West Virginia for a Halloween fest, where they come across Maynard Odetz, a serial killer. Maynard and his wife Delilah worked in a paper mill. The pollution from the paper mill seeped into Delilah's pregnancies. They had three sons, all of them deformed. The family isolates themselves into a forest in West Virginia where they become cannibals to survive. So the old man at the gas station, who dies in the second movie by being blown up with dynamite, is not their godfather, the actual father. That's why he tried to avenge them. The film then becomes a gore fest of how the youngsters try to run for their lives when Maynard and his sons hunt them one by one. In the end, all youngsters die. The events of this movie clearly take place between what happened in Bloody Beginnings and Wrong Turn. However, Bloodlines is slightly disconnected from its predecessor, as it raises the question that if Maynard and Delilah were the parents, and they isolated themselves in the wilderness, how did the three antagonists end up in an asylum in the previous movie? Some more coherency to the story would have been better. However, both films are supposed to be a gore fest. O'Brien had a limited budget for both the films, and he did the best he could with them. Now, we talk about the final movie of the franchise. Number 6, Wrong Turn 6, Last Resort, 2014. The movie follows Danny and his friends as they visit a resort, Hobbs Springs, that Danny just inherited. Apparently, it's a small portion, but even the small portion is bigger than what he expected. They soon get to realize that the place has an infamous reputation of guests missing every now and then, and they should keep an eye out for any doubtful activities. As they explore the resort, they are hunted by Three Finger, Sawtooth, and One Eye. Besides having a lot of sex in the movie, yes, a lot, it turns out that Danny is somehow related to the Cannibal Brothers. It doesn't actually make any sense, yet it's there. And Danny decides to become the manager of Hobbs Springs, where he will try to get food for his brothers. This is said to complete the prequel trilogy that Declan O'Brien started, but all three movies are so disconnected from each other that there is no coherent story. It's impossible to tell where in the timeline it fits in the Wrong Turn universe. Clearly takes place before the events of Wrong Turn, because the Cannibal Brothers are still alive, but how many months before the events of Wrong Turn? Or how many months after the events of Bloodlines? In an interesting turn of events, a court case was filed against the production company for showing the unauthorized image of a woman in Ireland as the missing person. Then 20th Century Fox pulled back all DVDs and Blu-rays 1 month after the movie was released, and it hasn't been repressed or re-released. It isn't available on any streaming platform either, but perhaps that is for the best. No one who's a fan of the franchise considers this canon, so maybe it's better if you just skip this one as well. And now we come to the last part. What is the future of the franchise, you ask? If we had been asked this question a few years before, we wouldn't have had an answer. Well, we would have, but would have been really vague, and you'd get nothing out of it. For this one, however, we do have something to say. Wrong Turn 7, The Foundation, is planned to be released sometime this year, as the news has it, but we feel that the current pandemic situation might have messed up the release dates. It's directed by Mike Nelson and written by Alan B. McElroy, the original movie writer. And this is going to be a reboot of the original movie. Since McElroy has taken his seat back as the writer of the film, we can expect it to be decent at best. Either way, let's not get our hopes too high. We wish we had a date of release, but that hasn't been revealed yet. So let's just wait for that date. And we hope this movie won't make the wrong turn that the last movie did. Do let us know in the comments how you are liking these massive explainer videos. Do you want us to continue with other subjects? Should we stop? What other subjects should we cover? Please let us know. And have an amazing day, and don't forget to be safe. This is all the time we had for today's episode. We hope you guys liked it. So it would be awesome if you guys could take some time to subscribe to our channel, and don't forget to tell us which topics you want us to cover in the comments section.